Hey guys, and welcome. My name is Dank, and today we're gonna do another voice of a lot of things online. We're gonna do the new big battle, Pelargir 6 Man, out of you as a Beorning. I said it's a voiceover, so it's not, live commentary. But it's a pretty good run. We don't get all platinum because I make a mistake, but we could have done it. Also, you see, our group is not perfect. We have two captains. You probably only want one captain and then get another DPS, and it would be a lot easier. But still, overall, it was a really good run. And we almost had all platinum. It's still a pretty good tutorial in what you have to do to get there, and what's the difference to the solo duo. Alright, so we got a warden. It's not the greatest either. You can probably run with all DPS. Captain is always amazing. Got a hunter and a burglar, which are good DPS, and then obviously me as Beorning. So I would have wished we had another DPS. So anyway, so the start is the same as in the duel. You just have to kill those guys. They have a little bit more hit points, but that's really it. The first big difference is, I gotta switch to engineering here. Just for the traps, the first big difference is that, well, you have to defend the guy who is turning the gate. You have to have two groups, one on this side and one on the other side. Way over there. The reason is both sides will get about the equal amount of people. And another difference to the duo is you're gonna get, I think I was AFK there for a second, running into the wall. The difference is that there will be torchbearers, which will actually attack the winch, so you have to defeat those fast. This part is still really easy. I mean, if you have a full six-man, you're not going to have any troubles there. It's kind of annoying how long it takes to get started. We see that they come out of this door in waves of four, apparently, and then they come out, a few come out of, up the stairs. Also, it's a good way because I finally got my Beorning geared a little better, so you can see some more damage, especially running with two captains. If you look at my buffs, I'm actually not two arms, but I mean, you can see there was a nice 38k hit with execute. If that was buffed, it would have been easily over 40k. Right now we have the Captain Banner. So we do 40% more damage. See what we can get on that crit. I missed it. Wow. That was bad. Well, I mean, you just have to defend this side. The other group defends the other side. And yeah, that's all you have to do. Focus the torchbearers. There you could see that some of the raiders will come up the stairs, but if you put the trap where we put it in the beginning, right in front of the door, they will still run into it. So he puts down a stun trap, I put down a bear trap, which, you know, I always feel bad as a Beorning putting down a bear trap, but that's what it is. Bear trap does really good damage, and I mean, the stun trap wouldn't have made sense because they already get stunned and then they're immune. You haven't used your time as a ranged DPS? Yeah, you do. You don't have to run after them, but it's not a big deal. Temple of probably the easiest time. So all you want to do is, you want to wait down here, kill them as they come up. If the other team wait on the other side and kill them as they come up as well. Here we got the four guys again, probably going to rent a small, yep. It's a good way to do it. And look at those hits. Do we have a banner there? No. Oh, some good hits. 9,000 there on every random small hit. It's pretty good DPS. And then once get the essence stuff going, that should even be higher. Because right now with 24,000 hit points, it's just way too much. It's not where you want to be. So yeah, this part unfortunately is a little boring. There's not much is happening. I don't know how long this will go on, unfortunately. I got another guy, put down another bear trap. Just makes it a little bit easier. The hunters helped me on this side, and then the Berg warden and one captain on the other side. I don't know where the other captain is. Those guys respawned, it's kind of weird. And I miss with my AoE. Not good either. These guys got a 16k hit with just a normal thrash, pretty good. Build up my wrath with the thing. Just check the winch, make sure that nothing attacked it, but it looks like my team is doing a good job. So we good here. There's no side quest in this part, which, you know, I don't know why not. But there's two side quests in the next part. Alright, so you guys see there's a torchbearer. I should focus him, but I think the hunter is doing a good job just killing them with his rain of arrows. I mean, hunters do pretty amazing damage. I'm just gonna have to wait here until stuff stops spawning. Got some pretty good crits there, he didn't make it long. Another big group coming. So this part you can probably, you know, do if you have two champions on each side. That's all you need. It's nothing crazy or difficult about this. Yeah, Hunter got a good 22k hit there. Probably two armed to Hunter. Let's see. Huh, I don't know if I cannot see the buff. But it doesn't look like... It looks like he two-armed the other captain, and the one captain is not doing anything. But it's not ideal. So this is just a random park group, so I don't know any of those guys. But yeah, it looks like the captain is not two-arming the hunter, or the burglar, which you want, but the other captain. And then one captain is not doing anything, which, you know, it's really not what you want. In case you don't know, two arms gives 25% extra damage for... Is it 15 seconds? 15 or 20 seconds. Anyway, we got our stage complete, merit awarded. We defended all the defenders and the winch survived. That's what we want. So the next part here is going to be a little different to the duo as well. You want five guys down at the entrance, where normally is, and one guy on the ballista. Ideally, you would want a tank on the ballista, but I'm actually taking that spot. I don't know why. Nobody else went to there, or I went there first. Just not ideal, and which will actually be the reason why we won't get platinum. Because you want all your DPS to be down for when the boss spawns. Yeah, well, I went there first, so that's why probably nobody else went up here. But stuff will actually attack the ballista, so you need somebody up here to protect it. In order to get platinum, you need to defend all the siege weapons, as you can see there on the side. But it helps to, you know, speed up the stuff a little bit. Alright, so all you want to do is build the ballista. Upgrade it. Probably should have upgraded the armor first, to be honest. I would just give it some extra hit points. Can see that my fellowship down there is setting up the barricades. As you should. Stuff doesn't have more hit points, you just get more half trolls, more sorcerers, and you get the torchbearers again. So we're gonna shoot the guys with the ballista. I said I should have upgraded the armor, I didn't. And there we go. That will hit even the guys in the front of it. And you know, you can just speed it up a little bit. That's all it does, it will speed it up to the next quest. And we'll see in a moment that we get attack up here as well. Now what you can do actually, you can still shoot a ballista while being attacked, while attacking. It's kinda stupid. So if you're up here, that this is what you want to do. You want to defend a ballista and just shoot it until the first quest starts. Once the first quest starts, you want to stop shooting because you want to slow it down. You don't want two quests at the same time. So the first quest will either be the thieves or the back to the wall. We will get the back to the wall. There we go. So now two guys have to go to the side. And we have to start taking...
I need one with me.
There you go, the leader is calling out. And we need to take down the grappling hooks to slow down the flow. I should not have attacked them. And also, I'm forgetting to take care of the ballista, which I need to check. I was seeing if I can check it from down here, but I can't. So I decided to take down more grappling hooks, but I should have gone.
The others that are back there, try to get the hooks off so it slows everything down.
Yeah, so the leader is calling out that we should take down the hooks to slow it down so we don't get two quests at once, same time. So you don't want to shoot a ballista anymore, because if you shoot a ballista, you're going to speed it up. So yeah, so we didn't pay attention, and here I make a mistake that I should have checked on this earlier, and well, you have to extinguish it and repair it. Oh yeah, I hit H for some reason and mount it up. So you only want to repair it, put on a trap, check on it from time to time, and then go down and take down the hooks, basically. So I put down a tripwire, go down, just help taking down hooks. Probably take down two, or the one, and then go back up. Oh, I'm probably gonna take down that one, yep. And then you go down, up again, check on the ballista. That's your job if you're on ballista duty. Obviously if you do the side quest, you gotta do the side quest, and if you're in the middle, you gotta defend it. There's nobody up here. But there were no hooks either, so I just decided to repair it a little bit. So two people right now are doing the side quest, which is really easy, and then the rest is taking down hooks. Well, three people are taking down hooks and defending the middle, and then one guy has to be on the ballista and do what I do right now. If you do it this way, you won't spawn the second quest, which will be always killing somebody. So we got a torchbearer there who's trying to attack the ballista. I do not have an interrupt out of bear, so he will actually get his fire off. But we'll be fine. You can see we can actually attack him at the same time as we extinguish the fire. I don't think you can attack the same time as you repair. I know you can load and fire at the same time as you attack somebody, which is always nice. So we're just repairing a little bit more. But if it gets destroyed, we lose platinum. Alright, so we got our first quest here. Got him platinum, so my team did a good job. And now we can, you know, start hitting again. I mean, maybe give them a few minutes to come back in position again, and then start hitting the ballista. Just speed it up to get the next quest going. So I was looking, make sure that everybody was back, and then I started shooting the ballista again. Cause once the next boss comes out, okay, so this is where I make a mistake. I see the torchbearer, and I was like, okay, I gotta kill that torchbearer before I come down. As soon as that quest pops up, you wanna go down to the boss. So I'm taking, 10 seconds here that I don't do DPS to the boss. Big mistake. Don't do that mistake. If you have that ballista, go down to the boss right away. So I missed the Oathbreakers, I missed 10 seconds of DPS, which is a lot. You have to kill him within, I think it's 45 seconds, or maybe less. We have pretty good DPS. I think we would have done it if I would have gone down right away. And yeah. So we get only silver in this. Which, yeah. It was not ideal. I think the ballista would have survived longer, but we did have the torchbearer up there. It was just a bad situation for that boss to spawn. But if you're in the same situation, go for the boss, don't go for the ballista. So already we lost platinum on the... We can't get platinum on the full run anymore because you need... you need to get platinum on all the side quests. That's why two captains are bad. You would want another, you know, hunter, champion, some good DPS. So nobody got anything good. One guy got a great essence of vitality, which is kind of useless, and great essence of resistance is not the best either. Only if you like tank, maybe. So this was the last side quest. So all you have to do now is wait. To do the waiting game, which is the annoying part about the big battles, is there's nothing else to do. It's like doing an instance, killing the boss, and then there's still trash coming. It's like, why? There's no point doing that. But anyway, somebody still has to defend up here, the ballista, and the rest just stands down there. Don't take down the hooks anymore. Because taking down the hooks will slow down the flow. You want to get done, so don't take them down. I don't know if my teammates are actually still doing that. Looks like it. You wouldn't want to do that. There's nothing we can shoot for the ballista anymore. Those guys in the back won't do anything, they're too far away. I'm still trying. It's like hoping that maybe I didn't see somebody. But as you can see, nothing happens. So all you can do, I could readjust it, like hit the side. But here I just want to show that you can shoot and load while you fight. So you can always do that. Just wanted to show that, I mean, as I said, there's nothing else to hit. Yeah, and this is why big battles are not as much fun as normal instances. you did the side quests, you got your merit basically, and now you just have to wait until all the guys come. And there's no challenge in it. It's, yeah, I don't know. Please don't make instances like this anymore. Yeah, it's devastated there on Thresh, 20k. It's not a hunter or a heartseeker or what's it called, upshot or whatever, but it's a pretty good hit. Yeah, just killing more guys. Do they even spawn down there anymore? Doesn't look like it. Oh yeah, there. Oh, okay, we will get a mini-boss who, you know, it doesn't give him merit, really. He just comes out and you have to kill him. Make sure he doesn't kill any of your defenders. But that's really it. It's not a 34k hit, it's pretty good. I mean, keep in mind we are out of the range of the captain buffs right now. We get two torchbearers at the same time. It's pretty good to rent a small. But yeah, normally you want you know, your guard up here or something. Something that doesn't necessarily need to be down there. You need to try is maybe setting a hunter up there and see if he can range down any boss that comes. A good hit here. So you can see them, so I think a hunter might be able to range them down from up here. I think the boss will spawn any second, hopefully. I'm sorry for this rather boring part of the video. But that's endgame in Lotro right now. All the instances are like old instances, so it's nothing new. This is at least somewhat new. This is actually the first time I've done the six men on this guy. Which turned out to be pretty good. Definitely has the DPS to to help with the bosses. I think we would have gotten platinum if I would have gone down there right away, instead of wait to kill the two guys and waste the 10 seconds.
Everyone on Kasung.
Okay, so the boss spawned. The leader just called it out, so we're gonna go down there. Put our debuff on there to help the DPS. And these guys have amazing mitigations. I mean, you can see that now those devastates from the other guys are like 20k devastates and the 11k in here. Now even with Oathbreakers, so we have Oathbreakers, Beast Swarm, and what we hit for. Can't even see it. 10,000 on the execute. I mean, that's kind of pathetic. So they have really good mitigations. If you look at, we had what, 4,000 DPS with buff going. It's pretty pathetic. Oh, okay, I see. One of the captains. Yeah, we should have traded if one of the captains actually is in blue line.
Grab some barricades, please.
In blue line. As you can see, he had Valiant Strike on. I just wanted to check if you used this. Maybe you can take the ballista with you, but you can't. So what you want to do is, after this is done, everybody should grab a barricade, if you can. You have to be Engineer 3, I think, to dismantle them. Just go ahead, dismantle them, and take them to the next stage. It just makes it a little bit easier. It takes a while, so if you're there, you might as well help. It just speeds it up a little bit. So there's, what, 4 barricades? I think we lost Defender. So we might have not gotten Platinum anyway. I think it's 9 defenders. But anyway, we should have gotten Platinum on that other quest. That's my mistake. And if we had a champion or something like that, it would have been... Instead of one of the captains have a champion, it shouldn't be too hard to get Platinum. So you just need a good DPS group. It's a DPS race. Alright, I came in to do the last hit. I'm checking if somebody reset the guys. So you always want to reset them to 2 handstands, because they do more damage. And they will actually survive longer, because stuff will hit them less, because they kill them faster, and they take less damage. If you put them in shield stance, they will actually take more damage, because it will take them longer to kill something. And then it will... You know, that will take more damage overall. If they're 200 cents, I kill them faster, they take less damage. This might not be true in the 6 mana if you're actively helping killing stuff. But if you're actively helping killing stuff, you can heal them anyway. So I would always put them in 2-hand. There's really no reason against that. If you can, upgrade the damage. I mean, it's a little bit of damage. So you want to set those up, it just helps a little bit. Makes your life easier. You want one guy on each of the catapults. There's one back there, one to the right here. And just start shooting these guys. Triple shot would have been better, but I don't know if he has that. Yeah, he just used heavy. That's fine too. And just, you know, help upgrading. Damage is not that big a deal, but every little bit helps. So you want to do the catapults until you spawn the first quest. And then as soon as the first quest spawns, either the Minstrel or the Archer, you wanna go over there. Oh, true. You actually get 2 quests here. So we got the Ship Slaves, which is a new quest. You don't get that, doesn't it do? So as soon as you get this, run over here. You need like 1 or 2 people.
People that know how to do that, go ahead and do it. Nice. I'm not too keen on where they are.
So you just have to free the slaves. And yeah, you just have to go ahead. So you want 1 or 2 just to speed it up a little bit. I'm alone. I think somebody's gonna come here and help me in a second.
You need help on our...
I don't have my microphone on. So I have to type. So you really only need 1 or 2. That's all. There's no boss here. Just go here to the side and then go up the stairs. go up the stairs here. And almost all the slaves should be up here. So you can see there's already 3 slaves. You need only 6. I don't think it's timed. I think you just have to get it done before something up. But you want to get it done fast because you don't want the next quest to spawn.
Try to keep taking those hooks off if you can't slow everything down.
Yeah, so the rest of the group has to keep down the hooks to slow stuff down. And then we just have to free those slaves. You don't have to defend them or anything. As soon as you free them, they're good. It takes a little bit for them to be recognized by the system as freed, because they talk a little bit. Should have moved my combat analysis, it's kind of in the way right now. Right, just go ahead, free them. We actually got a hunter too, we have too many people, you know, I think. And then the last one is right down there, and that's all you have to do. You don't even have to kill all the corsairs, you just have to free all the slaves. So there are some more corsairs on the side there to the left. But we don't have to defeat them. I actually completed Haradim Slayer. Alright, there you go. Got platinum on it. I got a good amount of marks and medallions. So if you have an accelerator, you should definitely use it. Got a nice tanking necklace. It's not bad. I'm going to switch back to officer because I want to make sure can heal defenders. Woo. I don't know if that was just on my screen or on your screen too. But everything went black there for a second. So I'm trying to find a captain. Just throw down a heal. Just make sure they don't die and then go back into engineer. Make sure the catapults don't die. If they die, you lose platinum. And now you want to trigger an express, so go ahead, shoot the catapults again, leave the hooks up. Make sure you spawn the next quest. So the next quest will be a killing quest, either the minstrel or the archer. So you want to go and kill that as fast as possible. Yeah, somebody should be on that catapult shooting. If you have a triple shot, it's the best. Remember, you can fight while operating the catapult. It's not a problem. Let's go ahead and shoot. There you go. So we got the archer. As soon as that spawns, drop everything and run over there. If the captain has its run buff, he should trigger the run buff.
Everyone on the archer.
Yep, everyone on the archer. Put all the debuffs we have on there. And again, I mean, that guy has amazing mitigations. I mean, the captains should put up Oathbreakers. There we go. We got a 23k execute, which is pretty good on them. We got here. So 13k execute, not that best. But overall, our DPS is a lot higher than it was in the other fight, and it's actually going to be high enough to get the platinum. There you go. So that's why I think we could have gone the other guy easily platinum as well. It's just my mistake for not running down there fast enough. And now again, this is all the side quests. So now all you have to do is wait, make sure nothing dies. Yeah, I'm the pessimist. I have to point out the bad thing. Yeah, now you have to just make sure the catapults don't die. Make sure none of the defenders die. And you're golden. You get one more mini boss, but he doesn't give merit. A nice 29k hit. The torchbearers will go for the catapults, or they will go for the barricades. We actually lost the barricade. I don't know if that will lose merit. I don't think it will. Because they're not technically not siege weapons. But you don't want to really lose the barricades either. It's probably what happened. Torchbearer went there and it burned down. So I'm just making sure everything is repaired. So make sure everything's prepared, and there's Aragorn slowly walking in instead of rushing in to save us. Yeah. Big bells. Excitement pool.
When we get the last right, moon head, bring him try to bring him over to this catapult.
Okay, so once in the duel, when this happens, only one catapult will have to shoot. And the six men that will come on both sides. Okay, so the slaves have been lost in the route. We still got it. I don't know, it must be a bug. Why that says it, but we got it. Okay, I guess I was wrong. There's still come only on a, on one side, on the left side here. So the right catapult is useless. I don't know why I show my marks here. Oh, because we get 733 marks, which is quite a lot. And there's Zaguroth or whatever. It's another mini boss. Again, there's no timer to kill him fast. But you might as well go ahead and kill him before he kills anybody else. Nobody actually shot that catapult, which is bad. That was a mistake. That will just drag out the things a little bit. Well, somebody got a great essence of tactical mastery, it's always nice. Alright, again, this guy has a lot of mitigations again. But he did get a 17k hit there. I don't know why I do rental small, it's kind of useless. Get the Oathbreakers, but we missed the executing the Oathbreak? No, we got it. But only 8,000. No, 11,000, 19,000. There's a little bit of delay in there. We do have a pretty good crit rate of 35%. That's always good. Should have refreshed the bees, but oh well. And after this, you should always make sure to put a heal on the captain. Just to make sure nobody dies. But yeah. Even if you're an engineer, it's better than nothing. But yeah, now again, the same game. We killed everything. The bosses are dead. The side quests are done. Now we just have to wait till the instance is over. Kill trash that doesn't give us anything. Yeah, it's kind of. I wish it would. It should just be over. Once you kill the boss, it should be over. Okay, this guy is taking down hooks. Don't take down hooks. If you take down the hooks, you just make it go longer. But yeah, so we would have gotten platinum if I would have gone down and helped with the DPS, which I didn't. And I apologize for that. So, I put up this video if you guys are in the same situation. Whenever the boss shows up, drop whatever you're doing and help DPS. Those bosses need to die fast. Yeah. So Aragorn is not even doing anything, he's just standing over there and being lazy. Could have helped us. And there we go. You got the stage. We only got gold because we missed that one quest. We got another tanking item, it's not so good, but we're gonna sell that one. The other one was better. Nobody got anything good just out of nothing because, I mean, you only got the gold. You can get the platinum reward there. I think I'm just gonna open the merit box to see if anybody got anything good. I don't think. I know we don't get anything good, we just get stars of merit. Oh yeah, and a crappy pocket item, which is useless. I'm just gonna sell it. But yeah, nobody got anything good. No one. Somebody got a supreme essence of finesse. Okay. Great essence of morale is nice. So I guess somebody got something good. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. And